In this video, we're going to show you two ways to move a flow item from one object to another, thus creating flow in the model. Let's quickly create a model. Drag out a source, a queue, two processors, and a sink. Connect the source, queue, and first processor, and also connect the second processor to the sink. Remember that connections can be made either by clicking the Connect Objects button in the toolbar or by holding the A key. The first way to move a flow item is simply to connect two objects using a regular connection. Connect the first processor to the second processor. By default, a flow item will move to an object connected in this way, just as it did from the source to the queue and from the queue to the first processor. Using this method, the flow of items can be directed by labels, item type, connection order, and many other options available to you in the object's flow properties. Click Reset and run the model. You'll notice the flow items move from object to object as dictated by those objects' connections. What you will see, though, especially when objects move from one processor to another, is that the objects simply appear at the next location instantaneously. This might be okay in some settings, when machines and conveyors operate in a gapless environment, but other settings might call for some type of transportation. Click Stop to stop the simulation. The second way to move a flow item is to use a form of transportation, and in this case, we're going to use an operator for the task, so drag out an operator from the library. We need to use a center port connection to link the operator to the first processor. Highlight the processor and check the Use Transport box in its Quick Properties pane. We're going to use the eyedropper-shaped sampler to make this connection for us. Click the sampler, then click the object we want to use for transport, which is the operator. Select the first option, Connect Object to Center Port, which will create a center port connection between these objects and correctly reference that connection in the Use Transport field. You could have also chosen the second option, which would have referenced the operator without making a connection. Either way, the sampler has done the work for you, and we're ready to transport flow items. Click Reset and run the model again. You'll notice the operator pick up the flow item upon the completion of processing at the first processor, and carry it over to the second processor. Notice that these two processor objects are still fully connected to each other. This is still essential for items to move from one object to another. They are simply being transported by another entity. Thank you for watching. For more information on FlexSim products, or to view more tips and tricks for successful modeling, please visit www.flexsim.com.